So, enough of that. Let's play something happier, like Doom. This was one of my old school favorite games, and it was just something I'd play when I'm just bored out of my mind and I just want to talk, because it doesn't really take much thinking. You just kind of go around and shoot shit. So, thought I'd play that, and then if you guys want to talk about horror movies and stuff like that, I'm kind of just... There's not even anyone in the room yet. I'm just kind of going. Let's start Doom. Right there, knee-deep in the dead. Yeah, let's try that one. Hurt me plenty, of course. I'm not going to go Nightmare. I don't want to have to think too much here. Ah, this song. I got this with the Doom 3 BFG. If you end up buying it, you get all three Dooms. You get Doom 1, Doom 2, and Doom 3, like a HD remix of it. And the cool thing is you can use the mouse for the original Dooms, which makes the game infinitely easier than using like the cursor buttons and then like the control and alt to like strafe and all that stuff. So it's regular WASD stuff. I forgot, you don't have to get any closer to shoot people. You could shotgun someone from across the screen, and it's just as powerful. Ah, the music in this game, too. So good. Sounds like it's about to start Master of Puppets by Metallica. Or Battery, even. I need a shotgun. I don't think you get the shotgun in the first one. Yo, Mike! Already done with your solo? Oh, wait, I think I get the shotgun here. I can still remember some of these secrets. Nope, no shotgun yet. There we go. I got the armor without losing anything. It's a hit or miss thing. Yeah, so what's your favorite scary movie there, Mike? What's your favorite scary movie? That's the way it should have been said, I guess. Nice and squealy. Gave it the Zach Wilde treatment. To strafe. All day. Not have to worry about reloading? Oh, man. These are the days. The golden age of gaming right here, folks. Yo, what's up, dude? You are up awfully late. I'm just, we're bumming out, man. Wes Craven just passed, so... Thought I'd just kind of talk about horror movies and stuff. What is your favorite horror movie? Everyone, what's your favorite horror movie? Alright, you gotta do this old trick. Kind of wait it out there. Holy shit. Yeah, that is late. Season 9? Wait, what? Season 9 of what? What did I miss? There we go. That's the spot I wanted. And there's my shotgun. Brutal Doom. No, it's not Brutal Doom. I didn't download the mod for it. It's just regular Doom. Well, Doom from the Doom BFG collection. Is the Scream season really good? Like, I don't know. I didn't give it a chance because it's on MTV, and I really fucking hate what MTV has become. So I think it'll be just like some teen drama bullshit. I didn't even think it would be anything like the Scream movie. Oh, Ninth Session. Oh, Session 9. Oh, god damn it. Dude, I am out of it. Alright. What's up, Sentry? Welcome back. Going old school today. Or tonight. 100% kills. 91% items. All the secrets. I just restarted the stream. Yeah, there was a Scream TV show on MTV. It just came out not too long ago. I haven't heard anything about it. I'm not really interested in it. Because once again, like I said, MTV fucks everything up these days. So it's not worth going to watch it. But if it is really good, maybe I'll give it a chance. But I haven't heard anything. All right, I got my shotgun. This is the only weapon I need in this game. Look at that. Oh, fuck. Yeah, no, YouTube's notification. I don't know. I just put it on my Facebook. That's pretty much. But YouTube's notification thing is really got to fix the, you know, they got to get their shit together. If they want to compete against Twitch, because Twitch will let you know whenever someone is streaming. It's not just like a luck thing. The music in this game, man, it still sticks with me. Oh, fuck. Just trying to make them blow up. Well, just like my regular one, it's facebook.com/KevinWK. Yeah, and that it did. There's it's here's the thing about YouTube. There's like donation buttons for certain people. There's no game sound. There's game sound. I just turned it down here. I'll turn it up. I just kind of turned it down just so it wouldn't be too overbearing. But there, that should be better. Let me know if that's better for you guys. I just didn't want it to overpower everything. How did he not die? He was hanging out right next to the barrel too. He was in blast radius. Yeah, so let's talk horror movies, guys. I don't know, I have to start off. One of my favorite all time is Night of the Living Dead. Like the original black and white one. That one scared the crap out of me when I was a kid. Because black and white movies tend to do that. I don't know why. It's just like, it's scarier when the blood, you know, like when everything's not so realistic, I guess? I don't know. But to think that movie was done in 1968 is crazy. Take it easy, man. Have a good one, Bada Buxa. Yeah, Night of the Living Dead, man, especially because it was one of those movies that, like, it ended, you know, it had a, like, not a happy ending, and I wasn't used to that. I think the first time I saw it, I was, like, 8 years old or something like that, and I just wasn't ready for that. It was playing on, like, PBS, like, it was late night, and it was just, you know, like I said, and the funny thing is I actually saw the black and, or the color version first, like, the remake in 1990. Saw that version first, and that one had somewhat of a happy ending, because, you know, people survived. But in this original, man, it was just desolate. There you go, get my backpack. Yeah, right? God, I hope not. And that dude smokes like a goddamn, like, 18-year-old. So I'm surprised he's lasted this long, in all honesty. Knock on wood. Knocking on all the wood. I would love to meet George Romero. Like, it's one of those horror convention things I would love to see him at. I've not had the luck of seeing him. Yeah, my dude, Thriller. The first time I saw that too, it scared me. Like the ending of it when he like smiles at the camera and he's all wolfed out, or like, yeah, whatever with the eyes. Crazy. Did I grab another card? No. This sounds like, actually this song's kind of funny, because it sounds like a Casio, like the Casio demo, where it just kind of changes the tempo, or changes the key of the song. Fuck. There we go. Alright, cool. Like an 18-year-old, damn kids in there smoking. Babadook was really good. I agree. The only thing I couldn't stand about Babadook was the kid. That kid was annoying as shit. But, you know, that's what most kids are. So, I guess he kind of came with the territory. I love that I don't have to aim. I can just shoot like that. And it pretty much kills everyone. Except that one dude that I'm going to go down and kill. let's see. But yeah, Babadook was really good. It Follows? I don't think I've seen It Follows. The STD ghost? I don't know, man. Wasn't that like Scary Movie 2? Yeah, if they would have killed off that kid, much better movie. I have not. Thomas has. He saw it last night and he was telling me about it. I'm going to have to pick up. I'm going to have to check out The Gift. You see that guy? He just disappeared. That was weird. Oh, there he goes. He's down there. Did he just... He just flew and... He just kind of disappeared. Good for him. All right. Oh, he's still down... How the hell... God damn it. Now he's not here. That is fucking with me. I haven't seen The Gallows yet either. I'm kind of behind on like newer horror movies. I still have to watch The Purge Anarchy. I've heard good things about that. We ran into one of the actors at a horror convention last weekend. It was the skateboarding dude with like white face and then he had like the cross on it. He was at the convention. And it was cool because he was there in full makeup and everything, had his skateboard. So it's pretty much, you couldn't confuse him for anyone else. But I still have not seen that movie. I heard it was a lot like The Warriors, which I love The Warriors. That's one of my favorite time movies. But it sucks because if you haven't seen The Warriors by now, you'll think it's the cheesiest movie ever. But like when you grew up watching it, man, it was, to me it's timeless. But it's very dated to other people who haven't seen it. I'm at King Diamond, yeah. I don't know what The Gift is about. Let's see. What is The Gift about? Oh, shit. Nope. Yeah, no shit. Hey, at least you're not even here there, Badabooksa. Like, we have to put up with that shit all the time. It seems like a joke that he's running. But then again, it's like, it's kind of typical of America right now. America is in a really fucking weird place. Excuse me. Yeah. So, America. America. And that's the thing. It's just like, I don't know, this country is fucked up right now. A lot like other countries, but we just make a lot of dumb decisions. We're more flagrant about our stupid decisions. I won't take it. Is it still in the theaters, or is it something that's like video on demand right now for The Gift? Words don't do it justice. I just don't feel like going to a theater to watch it. Yeah, we're... America is becoming more and more like the movie... Oh god. God damn it. Why is it every time I get on a stream, I just start brain farting? Idiocracy. Like, America's just becoming more and more of that. Where it's just some of the stuff you're like, really? Really, America? I'm sure if you're not from America, you're probably like, what the fuck are they on right now? Yeah, there you go. You got it. Damn late streams. Or stream delay. This is the best. I love the shotgunning. It is the most OP weapon in this game. You don't even really need to aim it properly, just in their general direction. I'm playing rap music. Oh, man. I wouldn't blame rap music. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff. I blame, if anyone can be blamed, it'd be Nickelback for cursing this country. Even though they're Canadian, they brought their poison over here. Butt metal. But, I don't know. Horror movies. So what's The Gift about? Like you guys never said. Or if you did, I missed it in chat. Here, let me grab this key. Oh, wait. Here's dudes in here. Oh, fuck. That strafe, though. Oh, I bet. It hurt me plenty. It's not too bad. How's the stream so far, guys? Is the quality up to snuff? Because I'm not really doing anything else. I just want to make sure everything's good on the stream. Give you that quality. I forgot how to get this guy. You gotta get down there and lower it. Oh, yeah. There we go. That's how.
I'm a computer. Stop all the downloading.
Rubble.
I'm a computer.
Let's see. Yeah. Yeah, that bald guy ruins it for everyone. I haven't figured out how to, like, take him off. Zoom throw. You gotta take care of the shotgun guys first, because they're the same way. They don't miss. If they shoot, they get you. You want the game volume up higher? Okay. Hold on. Like I said, I just kept it down. But if I'm too loud or something, let me know. There. That should be better. I get to hear those fun sounds. Love doing that. Crank that soldier boy. Oh shit! Somehow he missed. Afterlife? Another movie I should probably watch. I don't even know what that is, actually. I'm really behind in modern stuff. Like I said, I've been going back and watching a lot of the older stuff, like Phantasm and stuff like that. I actually went through the whole, like, four Phantasms in like... Hey, what's up, Brad? I went through the first four Phantasms just to basically get ready for whenever they drop Phantasm... whatever. Phantasm... I forgot what it's called. Not a reboot, but it's a new Phantasm movie that's supposed to end everything. Yeah, what's up, Brad? How you been, man? How's life treating you? Justin Long? Okay, I'm down with Justin Long and Christina Ricci. Oh, yes. Very into Christina Ricci. Oh, have you guys seen Tusk? The Kevin Smith horror movie? That movie was awesome. And Justin Long gets put through some shit in that. Plus, they've got the main character from Red State in there, too. Which was a fantastic movie, too. If you haven't seen Red State... It's pretty much loosely based on the Westboro Baptist Church. It's like if they were a cult of killers instead of a bunch of whiny fucking assholes. But yeah, that movie was awesome too. No, I heard about that. Like The Rock was like set to reprise the role, or not reprise, but The Rock was set to like play Jack Burton. And I was like, I don't know about that. Like, Kurt Russell pretty much nailed that. And that's a movie you don't need to remake. That movie was awesome the way it was. And it's like, I couldn't picture that movie being successful in today's film industry. That's like, that's the thing. Hollywood ran out of ideas, so they're just rebooting a bunch of shit that people liked in the 80s. Tusk is really good. Oh, man. North Carolina. How, so you're still out in North Carolina? You went back? That's cool, man. I am living out in Kansas now. I've been here for the past 3 years. Life is good. I still keep in touch with a lot of people, like Reese and all of them. They're all around. Star Wars Episode 7 is going to be great. I mean, from what I've seen of it, I've been trying to... I just watched the initial trailers. I haven't really gone too deep into it because I kind of want to keep it a little fresh, but, I mean, it looks great. I feel like the less I see of the previews and stuff, the better it's usually going to end up being. Oh, yeah, get that rocket launcher. Does. I forgot. Oh, Charlotte, North Carolina? Awesome, dude. Yeah, life without GameStop is definitely an upgrade. Once you leave GameStop, it only goes up from there. They're all at their, oh, crap. Everyone's at their GameStop conference right now, too, the manager conference. What do I have to do in here? Oh, there you go. Yeah, pretty much. I'm on the media blackout too. I'm not like, don't ruin the spoilers, but you know, if I can avoid watching it, I will. It's hard kind of being with a website that, you know, puts out trailers to not watch it, you know? That digital drum roll, all right. Where the hell? Somebody just fired a shotgun at me from... Oh, there we go. Just appeared out of nowhere. Nah, I'm doing this straight up. I don't even know what the God mode code was. What was it, like, IDDQD or something like that? I don't even think it works anymore in this version. Because you can get achievements in this. So they're probably like, no God mode. Because this is the BFG version of Doom. This is the one that comes with Doom 3, Doom 2. This part sucks because they have those like those same monsters, but they're invisible. Those big beasts. IDDFK. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Doom cover. Yeah. Wolfenstein was good. Wolfenstein was the first one I played. I played that in elementary school. It was like on the first IBM, someone put that on there, and I discovered it, and it was so much fun. I still play Wolfenstein. Actually, the Wolfenstein reboot by Machine Games was unbelievable. It was one of the best first-person shooters I played last year. And then the Old Blood I just finished recently, and that game was fantastic. Like, Machine Games knows what they're doing. I can't wait to see what else they do. But they killed it with Wolfenstein. It was a really good game, beautiful too. So, if you get a chance, if there's, you know, when there's a Steam sale and Wolfenstein's on it, dude, pick it up. It's really good. Great storyline. BJ Blazkowicz kills it as always. Let's see. Do the cheats work? IDDFK. Nope. Yeah, not working. Yeah. So I guess, like I said, I think they do that because there's achievements in here. They don't want people like getting the easy way in. Thought that was a secret. KMFDM. KMFDM is awesome. Best ever studios, I agree. I saw them at the Metro in Chicago, and I've never seen so many, like, it's a good thing I'm not epileptic, because that was the first time it was the second time I was ever in a mosh pit while the strobe light was going off. That is the scariest experience you could ever be in. Seriously, like, when you're in a mosh pit when the strobe light's going off, you'll see somebody coming right at you, and then you won't feel anything because no one will touch you. And then there'll be a time where it goes dark, and then all of a sudden you get hit. what the fuck? Like, that is the scariest thing. Do not mosh pit with a strobe light on. There's your life tip for the day. And KMFDM was like, almost their whole show is almost just all strobe lights. It was right during the KMFDM light tour.
KMFDM light.
What am I missing here? I'm just kinda just going through the motions. I mean, I could play other games too. I mean, love to see me play Mega Man. I don't have any Mega Man games. I've got the emulators, I guess. But man, I'm horrible at Mega Man games. I'll set it up. I mean, I can set it up soon for you. I'm just doing this because it's kind of mindless and we can talk and stuff like that. But yeah, the Mega Man, what was it, like anniversary or whatever just came out. Like, I think it's like $20 and you get like 1 through 6, which is kind of weird because, you know, I'm surprised they didn't just, you know, it's Capcom though, so I guess I'm not surprised that they didn't throw in like 1 through 10, just the whole Mega Man original series, you know, including the two that were on Xbox and PS3. Because, I mean, it's not like it's hard to reproduce those, seeing as they're, you know, just old-school graphics. But, once again, it's Capcom. They're gonna cash cow that shit as far as they can go. Bones. Yeah, I'll wait till that's on sale. And plus, the only way I could really do it, like, I would have to get save states going, man. I need a save state, because I'm going to die so much in that game and get so frustrated. Like, when I was a kid, I was a Mega Man kid friend, and then I thought, you know, like, I'm like, I suck now, but if, you know, once I get older, it's got to get better. No. I was actually worse at Mega Man as I grew older. What am I missing? I'm missing, like, a Switch. Yeah, I would, you know, if they did come out with the Mega Man X collection for like a digital, like, you know, try to spiffy it up and everything, that would be worth buying. Mega Man X was like, that was a fantastic collection. I think me and Thomas were talking about that the other day, and so good. Oh, fucking idiot. There it's right there. God damn it. But yeah, I would definitely be down for that. Even like, I'm a weirdo, man. I actually really like the Mega Man Battle Chip collection. Was that Battle? Not Battle Chip, but Mega Man Pout? The one that came out on Game Boy Advance, where it was basically like an RPG with Mega Man. Mega Man Battle Network? Battle Network. That's what it was. I was a fan of those. Those were really good. At least the first two. I didn't go beyond that. Because at that point, they turned into Pokemon, where it was like Battle Network Red, Battle Network White. And I was like, I don't need those extra ones. Shit. Fuck. The first time I ever played Doom was on the the Sega 32X. Mega Man Battle.net. That would be fantastic. Oh, see? The invisible ones. That would be awesome. Blizzard presents Mega Man. Like, Mega Man. They should have Mega Man cards in Hearthstone. Now that I would buy a pack of. Even Mega Man card backs. Come on. Oh, by the way, Thomas, if you're listening too, I finally unlocked Tavern Brawl. After all these years. Cosmic Carnage? Yeah. Cosmic Carnage was a good game. I thought I was the only one ever on the planet to own a 32X, man. I was a Sega fanboy growing up. I had the Sega Genesis, I had the Sega CD, the 32X, I even had the Sega Channel. That thing was super rare. It was basically a service that you bought. Back before Comcast was Comcast, I think it was called Prime in Chicago. And they had the Sega Channel, where it was this thing you attached onto the top of your Genesis like a cartridge, but it had a modem connection to it, and it connected you to like 30 or 40 Genesis games, and they all changed every month. It was awesome. I pretty much quit Blockbuster for a while when that happened. Like, I didn't have to rent any games because they were all on the Genesis. fuck? It's, you know, and then it just goes to show, man, Sega Genesis, or Sega in general, man, they were way too ahead of their time. Yeah, rest in peace, Wes Craven. Nice, random fights. Sorry, I'm just catching up to the chat. Yes, I did have a Sega CD, Century. One of my favorite games to play on Sega CD was, weirdly enough, the Terminator. Terminator was really fun. It was just a... I have that, actually, on emulator. But it was a side-scrolling, like, just shooter game. I love the Terminator, by the way. I'm a huge, like, Arnold fan and stuff like that. Anyone who knows me knows I quote Arnold all the time. But the Terminator side-scrolling game was really fun, and the soundtrack was amazing. Sonic CD was amazing. Dreamcast, best console ever, I agree. What the hell? You're a son of a bitch, Walter. Hold on, let me see what he knocked over. Cats are assholes. Just goes. I don't know what he knocked over, but he looks like he's like a fucking boss. He's like, yeah, I did it. What? I just hear a cup knocked over. I don't think there was any cups. He's an asshole. Yeah, you know what? I started watching Scream 2, and then I got bummed out and just turned this on. I was like, you know, I might as well just stream, and we could talk about movies and all that and cheer up. I got through the first scene in Scream, and that was about it. Cats are... I love my cat, dude. He's fucking adorable, but yeah, he's an asshole. But the thing is, when company comes over, he plays like the perfect fucking... Like, everyone loves him. He's like the sweetest cat ever. Then when everyone leaves, he goes back to being an asshole. Come on. Shit was getting tense. Stick with the beagle. And you know, the thing is, like I said, it's the complete opposite. They're polar opposites. Where Walter loves people, and Reggie is just very timid around people. So it's hard to, like, you know, when I take Reggie out for walks and everything, he starts barking at everyone. Pretty much anything that moves, he barks at. And then, like, you know, he's adorable. He's a good pet. But barks at everything. And it's like, Walter is the complete opposite. He's just completely laid back. This cat lets me rub his belly. Cats never let you do that shit. All glory to Walter. That's true. Especially when, this is back in the early, when it came out, like the mid-90s, I think in 95 or 96, when it came out, they had the, a little while later, they had the director's cut come out. And the director's cut had way more blood in it. And they actually show, like, at the beginning, the boyfriend's guts kind of, like, go rolling out of his stomach. It's really cool. The days of director's cuts. Gotta get that armor! Boom. Yes. More comments below, hold on. Something's... Burp. Yeah. Hearthstone. I was talking about Hearthstone. I got addicted to that thanks to my coworkers. Oh, man. Yeah. At least you went back and enjoyed the classics, dude. I mean, it's like, for any kid these days to play something like this is an eyesore. Oh, goddamn, I missed that ball. Ah, well. But yeah, Doom laid the groundwork for a lot of these first-person shooters and just scary games. I remember being freaked out playing this as a kid. I don't know, man. It's gonna get to the point where you're basically just watching someone murder someone in, like, complete HD where it looks like through a glass window. I'm curious how it goes with the special effects. How can the special effects get better, you know? It's like video games. Look at that. I mean, video games get more and more realistic every day. But obviously, they're gonna hit a point where you just can't get any more realistic. So, I mean, I wonder when we're going to hit that point. It seems like it'll be soon. I mean, I think the only thing they can really improve upon is the AI. at this point. Like, graphics are gonna get better, yes, but the AI is the only thing that, like, I would say, once they got the graphics to, like, to where it is humans on screen and animals and everything like that, fuck. It's just gonna get to the point where it's just, all they can do is work on AI. Even, like, look at, Hideo's, look at Metal Gear, but I mean, look at his engine. Like, the Fox engine. Like, it's unbelievable. That and Unreal Engine 4. Like, some backgrounds, like, the environments look like it's a real environment. Yeah, you're right, and that does depend on streaming power. But, I mean, look at this. Google's already taken a sort of gigabyte, and now everyone else is following suit with the gigabytes and stuff like that. It's just like, it's going to be only a matter of time where you're not going to have to worry about internet speed. Because there's not going to be anything that you need to download that can be... I'm saying this now, and you know it's going to be like next week, Google's going to be like, 2 gigabytes! But I mean, it's just like, there's so much right now. I mean, we're a lucky generation, man. We got a lot of shit. I was talking about it yesterday when we were, you know, just kind of shooting the shit with a friend. And we were just saying, man, it's like, how lucky do we have it? Our fucking computers are in our hands. Like, yeah, I'm not going to go old man on you, but it's just, I appreciate what we have today. It's hilarious to think back, like, if I can go back and, like, live in the 80s again. It's like, some aspects of those would be fucking horrible. Like having a pager instead of a cell phone. It's like, oh man, somebody's trying to get a hold of me. Let me go find a payphone. Oh, they typed 911. That means it's important. Yeah, and sitting through dial-up. Dial-up was the worst. Downloading porn was the worst thing ever on dial-up. Like, you just saw the image, like, come down, like, doop, doop, doop. Like, by the time it finishes, you're already finished. That's right. I went there, folks. Pages were... the pages were in the, like, late 80s. I mean, because look at it in, Terminator, 1984. They had pagers. They weren't available to everybody, but they had them. In Terminator 1, which was filmed in, 83 or 84, the doctor in that movie, when they had the police scene, he's got a pager. It just became commercially available probably around the early 90s, or like more affordable. I mean, think about it, that's crazy stuff, isn't it? Like, when I was a kid, they were having, like, you know, I had like a 486 computer, and it had like 256 megabytes of memory or RAM. Not even RAM, but like hard drive space. And then I remember, like, the computer seller or whatever at Best Buy was like, this computer comes with 4 gigs of hard drive space. You're never gonna need more than 4 gigs. 4 gigs won't even get you a Blu-ray movie anymore. It's funny how that goes. Phantasmagoria? I have not, but I've heard good things about it. I think I downloaded that from Good Old Games. Otherwise, it might... Yeah, I think I have that on my Good Old Games account. I've got to really play that. I heard good things. Even though it's a older game. What is it, like a point-and-click adventure? Let's see. Dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo. Pretty much you just go where there's... If you ever get lost, just try to find people that are still alive. That's how you know you're going the right way. I think so. Or at least it had a lot of full motion video sections. You know what game let me down in the 90s that I thought was going to be the coolest fucking thing ever? Night Trap. I remember all the controversy that surrounded Night Trap, and I was like, I have to own this game. And I went out of my way trying to find it. I found it at a GameStop back when it was Funko Land. Found it at a Funko Land. Pretty much had like someone who was 18 buy it for me. got home and played it and just like just was let down immediately. Like, it's such a fucking cheesy game, and there was no reason for it to be. Oh fuck. There was no reason for that game to have to get banned or go through all kinds of the shit that it went through, because it was awful. It was those dudes with the vampires in that game. Vampires, dudes in like fucking black suits, and all they did was fucking just capture people with these weird like hooks. God, I'm breaking shit over here. It was just bad. If you ever get a chance to play Night Trap, don't. Just watch a Let's Play on it. Especially because it's so confusing. You have to control all these cameras, and you have to set traps to when these guys walk by, and if you don't, then the video just keeps playing, and then they capture some girl, or they just go on their way. And it's really weird, because there's no way. I mean, you have to play through the game multiple times to know where everyone's going to show up, because it's the same video. They just they just go through everything at the same. So if you beat it one time, you never really need, there's no replay value to it. Dana Plato. Yeah. Dana Plato. Thanks, dude. I grew up on Doom, man. I love this. The only thing that sucks is I don't remember where I'm supposed to go. So I just kind of end up wandering. But that's what conversation's for. But yeah, Night Trap. Garbage game. And that was back in the days of like when you try to watch the videos and the videos are so pixelated, it looks like you're watching something on YouTube at like 144. And it's just, the 32X came out and they made better versions of them, but even those versions were they were clearer, but that was about it. What the fuck? I need keys. I need the keys. Oh, hey, buddy. There you go. Oh, fuck. Yeah. You know what? I got one of them, Thomas. I got the white dude that's hanging out in there. I couldn't get to the guy in the tower. Like, he was way too hard to get to, and I accidentally killed him. So, I'm gonna try again. But yeah, I did get one of them on the helicopter. And like the helicopter guy's like, are you sure? He's like, alright, I guess that's weird, but okay, I'm not going to question your methods. So I got to get the other one. Primal Rage. Dude, if you ever get back to Chicago, Brad, there is a arcade out here now called the Galloping Ghost. Well, out there. And they have the prototype version of Primal Rage 2. They never came out. It was basically, they made the game, they didn't finish it, but they released what they had, and Galloping Ghost got themselves aboard, and so they hooked it up. It's pretty cool. But it's the only place you'll ever get to play that, ever, anywhere. God, I need the yellow one now. But yeah, Primal Rage 2, it's pretty cool, man. I didn't expect it. But yeah, that was that character Chaos or whatever. He would just fart on people. And then if you got hit by the fart, you were like knocked out or you were like confused. Damn it. Damn it. Find a way out. Ah, here we go. Nope. I guess this is the way. Yeah, I don't want to fall down that way. Wait, what the hell? I don't know. But horror movies. We're going off track here. I don't know. Lately, I would say the one horror movie that stuck with me besides Babadook, there's a movie called You're Next. I thought that was pretty cool. So Kane Hodder, he played Jason in a lot of the Jason films. Pretty much, I think, 6 through 10. And he has, a slasher movie called Hatchet. If you haven't seen Hatchet, make sure you see that, too. That was really good. I mean, it's pretty much like a redneck version of Jason. And they have a lot of cameos in there by, you know, like the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre and stuff like that. There we go. That's what I was looking for. Friday the 13th on NES, dude. I love that. It's so bad. By getting Syndicate. Syndicate, like, are they re-releasing it? I remember they were doing... No, I don't think they were doing, like, two versions of it, were they? Because I remember the first-person shooter that came out on EA, or by EA, a couple years ago, which I have, and it's eh. But the, yeah, so the Hatchet series. I don't know, I'm getting off track. I'm easy. Yeah, Hatchet's awesome. I like that a lot. Oh, fuck! Danielle Harris is awesome, too. She's really cool. Oh, Assassin's Creed. Now, you know me. I mean, you're the huge Assassin's Creed fan. I can't do it, man. The last one I even got into was 4. And that was pretty much... I couldn't even finish that. I just got into it because it was pirates. The thing I liked about Your Next was the... I mean, it was pretty good twist and a lot of good gore. Actually, you know what's another movie I just... Oh, man. It's not so much horror, but it was like very in the vein of Saw. The Collector and Collection. Both of those movies were awesome. I don't know. I'm just got ADD tonight, so I'm going to be skipping all over the place with subjects. Yeah, I am the worst, Brad. I'm sorry. Are you hyped for that new movie they just announced? Assassin's Creed. Well, I guess the movie. Michael Fassbender. I think they're going to make him Ezio. I don't know if they're going to make him Ezio or they're going to make him, what was it, Altair. No, Your Next was the one where the guy takes his girlfriend to dinner with his family and, like, somebody starts killing everyone. I'm not going to spoil it from there. I feel like I'm going back to the same damn area. Whoa! Where did you come? Oh man! Metal Gear is almost here! Mad Max as well, I've got them both. Like I was saying earlier, on cdkeys.com you can get Mad Max for $20. So even if the game sucks, it's only $20. But it looks good. It looks really good. I heard like a beard. Oh, there they go. Wow. Hey, what's up, Erelix? Thanks for hanging out, man. Where are you from? That it's 4 a.m. Let's see. What time is it here? 10. So it's about, what are you in? England? England? Slither was fantastic. Dude, Slither was so good. I have not seen Vacancy. I like Slither a lot. That was the dude who did Guardians of the Galaxy, James Gunn. And also did Lollipop Chainsaw with Suda51. Suda51 is so... I love that dude. He's pretty much like a wacky Hideo Kojima. Oh, UK. Awesome, man. Thanks for tuning in, dude. I appreciate it. If I'm not streaming on here, I'm usually streaming on Twitch. If you want to follow me on there, it's just twitch.tv/KevinWK. That way you get more notification when I'm on there. I don't know why YouTube doesn't send out notifications when people go live on this. Because I would love it. Like, some of my favorite people, if they're streaming live, I want to be there to watch, you know? Shit, run! There you go.
Give to me.
Where the hell did that come from? Forgot how I get out of here now. Yes, I am super excited for the new Evil Dead game. Oh man, it looks so good. What's up, Stoney? Welcome back. Let's talk about Teeth. Ooh. Yeah, Teeth was a good movie, but yeah, as a guy, it's hard to watch. Oh. Fuck. So much. Yeah, the new Evil Dead series is going to be amazing. And it's Sam Raimi, like, he's helming everything. Bruce Campbell's back. Like, it looks like they didn't miss a beat, which is great. It's cool that they're actually finally, Hollywood's starting to realize that they need these people to come back. You know, people aren't just going to, like, love a reboot without the originals, you know? Brad, have you ever met Bruce Campbell and be like, we're brothers, or we're twins, or we're cousins, or you should call him Uncle Bruce? I can't wait till Sony does their PlayStation View when it comes to my area, because that's the whole thing where you can buy like channels a la carte. You don't have to go cable, you can just get like whatever channels you want, and that'll be fantastic. Because I want El Rey Network, because From Dusk Till Dawn Season 2. By the way, have you guys seen the From Dusk Till Dawn series? I'm gonna bore you, like, I bore Thomas with it all the time. But the From Dusk Till Dawn series was actually really good. They're in the second season now, they just had their first episode last Tuesday or Wednesday. Yeah! Oh, are we talking about Twin Peaks? Yes. I'm sorry, I'm just kind of going back and forth the chat. Yeah, Twin Peaks, man. I can't wait. Yeah, Lynch is back, and they actually went from, like, they were going to shoot originally, like, 9 episodes. Now they're going to do 18 episodes. So, I mean, they doubled everything. Like, Showtime's like, we got to have this show. So, good on Showtime. But the, was I talking? God damn it, see, I brain fart. See, I did see that new Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Like, they did it again. It's like, how many times do you have to reboot that fucking film? I don't know. It gets really old really quick. I get it. You guys love rednecks. Let's make something different. Or give Rob Zombie a chance to do Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Which will pretty much do House of the Thousand Corpses again. Which, I was not a fan of House of a Thousand Corpses, but I love Devil's Rejects. I think Devil's Rejects just had a much, like, the soundtrack was really good. And just, like, I don't know, it was just much better than House of a Thousand Corpses. And I think the reason being is, like, Universal cut out a lot of shit from House of a Thousand Corpses that we may never see. Like, they, you know, when they originally were going to release House of a Thousand Corpses, it was, like, rated NC-17 and had all this shit in it that was supposed to be pretty fucking crazy. But once again, they had to cut a bunch of shit to make it rated R. So who knows? I mean, that could have been a decent story that they fucked up because they had to cut everything. There's a new Doom reboot? What's up, Jason? How you doing, man? I'm the Doom game reboot looks fantastic. I would love to get in touch, like, getting with that. Bethesda's been, you know, doing pretty well for themselves as far as getting reboots that people actually like. Like I said, like, a la Wolfenstein. Yeah. Devil's Rejects was fantastic. And the funny thing is, they had an unrated version of Devil's Rejects. Like, when it came to DVD. Yet, we never got, like, an unrated version of House of a Thousand Corpses. The thing I like about Rob Zombie, too, is his, as a director, he had some... I'm not gonna play Hearthstone. I'll get my ass kicked. he has his, like, stable of actors that will always be in there, and he goes with these retro actors that were amazing. Like, you know, getting Ken Foray from Dawn of the Dead. He's in there, you know, and getting, like, a lot of the Grindhouse people. Like, fucking Captain Spaulding. I can't remember his name now, once again. He got him in there, and he's been in a bunch of, like, Grindhouse films. Just a lot of really, was it Forsyth? Michael Forsyth? Like, a lot of great actors, and they, you know, just kind of, like, got left by the wayside, you know, because Hollywood wanted newer people. But he brought these people back, and they do a fucking phenomenal job with their roles. Like, the Halloween reboot, I'm one of the few that actually liked it, especially Halloween 2. Halloween 2 is fantastic to me because he was a lot more... Michael Myers is a lot more aggressive. Like, his mask is hanging, like, halfway off his face, and he's got a beard. And it's just, when he's stabbing people in it, like, he's grunting and everything. It's like, it was way more raw than I thought it would be. And I don't mean raw in, like, a weird 90s, like, dope term. I mean, like, raw as in, like, it was fucking disgustingly awesome. Groucho Max. Groucho Marx? Yeah. Not that Captain Spaulding. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, no, like, Aliens in Isolation. I was playing that the other night. Oh, actually, I was playing that last night. Yeah, that's good, where you have to actually run from them instead of try to fight them. Like, those... It's cool, it gives it a whole new feel to it. Like, I liked... the other game that kind of, like, was... That was the inspiration for Alien Isolation. Outlast? Yeah, there you go. Outlast was cool, the ending sucked. That ending... Like, that game went on far too long. And then the ending was... Just made no sense. But the... like, those type of games were fun, and yeah, they were scary because you couldn't fight them, so you just had to run and find a place to hide. You know what, Aralex, I have to say right now, Metal Gear Solid 5, I'm really hyped for that, because I've always been a huge Metal Gear fan. Also, Fallout 4, like, I've got the collector's edition for both systems, or like the Pip-Boy edition, like, that's going to be amazing. There's a lot of good games coming out this year, thankfully. And I'm not a huge Call of Duty fan, but Black Ops is my favorite one. Just because after the whole Infinity Ward, like, you know, dissolving, Treyarch was the only one making good Call of Duty games. So I'm excited for this year's rendition. Plus, I'm getting that collector's edition because it comes with a freaking fridge. Like, you know, a little mini fridge. How can you go wrong with that? It makes all the juggernog sounds when you, like, open it and stuff. Where is it going? Shotguns from across the room. Shenmue's gonna be awesome. Yeah, I helped kickstart that. I put $60 down for the collector's edition on PC. Or not the collector's, the physical disc edition. I should do Brutal. I gotta download Brutal Doom. Yeah, when Doom comes out next year, that's gonna be fantastic. It's too bad that Doom's not coming out until, like, April or May of next year. But there's people playtesting it already. I know somebody that got to play it, the multiplayer, and he said it was really good. Shoddy snipes. All day. 360 no scope. There we go. Oop. Boom. you don't even have to really aim. It's the easiest game in the world. Just point in the direction. Check your Steam, yo. Oh, I'll have to check in a second. Hold on. What? Hold on. Is it buffers? I don't... No, no one's in my stream right now. Weird. Is everyone still having the buffering problem with this? Yeah, Mafia 3 looks fantastic. That reveal trailer? Oh, man. They killed it with the soundtrack, and like I'm looking forward to that as well. I liked Mafia 2 a lot. I wasn't a fan of Mafia 1, but Mafia 2 really kind of brought me on board. Then yeah, Mafia 3, good story time, like, you know, or like timeline. Cool. Sweet. Good. Well, I'm glad, like, I don't, you know, like, I've got a shitty upload speed. But I'm glad it's working out. I think once I try multiplayer or something like that, it's gonna just crap out. My machine's gonna explode, or my modem will explode. Oh crap. Scout Trooper added me to a friends list. Alright. If one of you guys is a Scout Trooper, thank you. Oh fuck! There we go. This is one of my favorite songs for the Doom soundtrack. It's just so creepy and so, like, no hope sounding. Like that weird MIDI guitar right here. Oh, that's you? Okay, cool, Sentry. Thanks. I'll add you once I get all this stuff together. Yeah, if you guys want, I'll stream Metal Gear Phantom Pain. I don't know if you guys are into spoilers and stuff, but I mean, I have no problem streaming it. God, I'm gonna play the shit out of that game. I may not be as, like, active in the chat or anything because I want to get into the game, but I mean, if people want to watch it, I'll do it. Rockets! Too easy. Oh, dude, of course I know what MIDI is. There you go. Too easy. I love the map in this. Oh, they don't... I forgot how to display the map. There we go. Yeah, right? It is definitely a game where you just watch. I remember playing Metal Gear Solid 4. Playing Metal Gear Solid 4 and, like, folding laundry because it was nothing but, like, a non-stop cutscene. I beat the big badasses! That was all kinds of messages going on here. All messages. Oh god. I didn't see the dress code thing. So much text. Look at that ending right there. It does. I want to stream Until Dawn. I might do it next weekend because I have a friend of mine coming in town and he wants to see it. So we figured might as well just have like a stream party or something like that. So, Scalebound? I've not seen that. Oh, it was... No, that was something else. Which one's Scalebound? Because I'm thinking of the game that... what was it? Ready at Dawn was doing... Or that wasn't Ready at Dawn. Somebody was doing a game that looked fantastic where it was kind of like Dark Souls or like weird robo-dinosaurs and shit. Yes, it does, Jason. I agree. Horizon, that was the game I was thinking of. Like, let's see. Let's try something different here. Any requests? Name a game. Right, let me approve people here. Why do I need to sign? What? I'm on the app, stupid. It was like trying to make me sign in. Nah, whatever. Let's see. Let's, you know what? While we have everyone, try some Ground Zeroes. Yes, the map making in Doom will be fantastic. Cool, Aralex, take it easy, man. Thanks for stopping in, dude. I appreciate it. Stop in anytime. Let's see if this... Hold on. Make sure everything's... Ah. I gotta window this. What the hell? Alright. Custer's Revenge? Really? Who has that game? Come on. Like an old Atari game. That is not very PC. I don't know if you can get banned for playing a game like that, but it's very frowned upon. There we go. God damn it. This is why you should play Windows. Window mode. There we go. Yeah, it's just really weird. Don't you like hump like Indian women or something like that? Or Native American women? Alright, I'm going to try the mission where you have to get like the hand and the eye or whatever. I'm going to try to kidnap them both. I kidnapped one of them already. Do the mission saving Kojima? Okay, cool. I'll do that one next. Thomas killed Kojima.
Boss, the mission objective is to eliminate two U.S. Marines officials.
God, this game does look really good.
The pair were in Laos together, but retired after the U.S. withdrew its forces. They were a sniper spotter team. In country, they were known as Glass
Night Vision
and Palettes. The eye and the finger. I've sent VIs of the targets to your iDroid. Take a good look.
Fuck 'em.
Remember, boss, this is...
Oh, I did it the wrong way. Shit, I was gonna throw him off the cliff. Oh man, that scene in Escape from LA. God. No, I didn't get that one. You know what? I'm going to do that right now. I didn't get any patches yet. I should go look for those patches. I haven't even tried. That's why I forgot to do that.
The pair were in Laos together, but retired.
Yeah, you roll around.
They were a sniper.
It's like that.
In country, they were known as Glass and Palettes. The eye and the finger. I've sent VIs of the targets to your iDroid. Take a good look.
Gonna get him.
Remember, boss, this is a sneaking mission. If you're detected, the targets are bound to take
I love
extra
that.
Precautions. It's crucial that you eliminate the targets quickly.
Cool, Jason.
Quietly.
Thanks, dude.
Do not let the enemy.
I appreciate it, man. Thanks for stopping by. Go for that headshot. Ah, whatever. I don't need to bother him anyway. This guy's the guy I want. Oh, really? Okay. Jack Burton skin? That would be fantastic. Yeah, not a good way to die.
The clients are KGB contacts from my Columbia days. Don't worry, they had nothing to do with Zadornov. They lost a lot of comrades to the eye and the finger. The NVA lost high-ranking staff too, but also their families, their children. To the east, the two were a reason to be afraid of the dark. Their extradition to face trial is even on the table in the peace talks. Now that they're out of Laos, the two are enjoying a relaxing vacation in a loophole.
There we go.
By minefields and barbed wire. Even if the war ends, the east fears their return. For our clients, it will only truly be over when these two are dead.
I don't know how that worked. I did some bullet bending shit. He's like doing all kinds of dramatic flips down there. Yes! That'd be awesome. Snake running around in his underwear. Get in there! Yeah, it is. Good call. Oh man, PT would have been such a great game. Really? God damn it. Who sees me? Oh, up there. Go for it. I'll wait here.
CP, this is Delta 2. Still no hostiles around here. We're standing down. Over. This is CP. Understood. Stand out. Stand out. Out.
Don't know what those dudes are staring at. Nice. That's some distance.
I've sent VIs of the targets to your iDroid. Take a good look. Open the menu tab, then select...
Cool, take it easy, Brad. Good seeing you again, man. Have a great one. Yeah, enter the numbers from PT. You know those numbers were Kojima's birthday, I think? Oh, fuck. Oh, I killed Kanye. Put him to sleep. I'm just gonna like scare everyone. It was fun though. I still love that too when you were playing and I just like banged on the door and scared the crap out of everyone. I think this is him. Yep.
You found him. That's target A.
This is who I need.
The map has been updated.
Run! Run, you fools! Shit. Who? Fuck him. I'm booking! Hot zone!
Hey,
Oh, fuck. Oh, come on. Stay in one place while I kill you. There we go.
One target down, one to go. His buddy's on his way to hell.
Wait, did he just kill him? Oh! Wake up! God damn it. Alright, I'm gonna do the Hideo mission, because that sucks. That sucked. I almost got away with it. That sucked. All right. Intel operative. This one's a fun one anyway, because you get to just shoot everyone. That's the whole, like, the whole object of this one. It's like, fuck going in stealth. Just go there and shoot everything that moves. I forgot how this goes, too.
We got a request for extraction from a member of the Intel team who was working undercover at the prison.
I love how they, yeah, oh man. Konami fucked up so bad by just, like, getting rid of Hideo Kojima. I'm sure we don't know the whole story and all that, but I'm sure Konami's to blame for that shit. But, once again, it would be the biggest trolling in the world, which I wouldn't be surprised from Kojima. To where this whole situation with Konami was just hype for Metal Gear. Like I said, I know that's unbelievable, but I wouldn't be surprised if Kojima came out and, like, said, no, you know, me and Konami are all cool, and Silent Hills is still coming out, and all this stuff. Troll-a-lo-lo-lo. That would be unbelievable if that was true.
Check your surroundings carefully. Watch out.
Shoot the damn bird. You guys know about this? Easter Island head? Maybe that's an Easter egg? Ah. God damn it. Yeah. That would be hilarious if somehow, like, all that shit. I mean, it would be hilarious. It would be the troll of the century. Can I not? There we go. Break it all.
A vehicle. Did he steal that from the enemy? Not bad.
Oh, I almost got it from afar. There you go, look at that dude fly. Except for the one guy that's still there. He's still alive. Good timing. Will this guy fucking die already? God.
I'm good to drive. Just cover me.
Sorry. Yeah, this is Ground Zeroes. I'm just getting ready. I'm doing the Hideo mission where you rescue him. Just getting ready, getting the controls ready for Phantom Pain. It'll be so good when it releases. Oops! Oh, he's still alive. Come on, he was moving a little bit. Far Cry was so good. I loved getting through all the other... just getting through all the actual... like, liberating the bases and stuff. That was one of my favorite parts.
Touchdown is a no-go. Run
helipad. There we go. Oh man, it's gonna be your first one? Did you, it's good to watch, like, there's a 7-minute video on YouTube, kind of catches you up to the series. That way you're not too completely into it. Oh. Metal Gear Solid 2 was pretty good, but Metal Gear Solid 1 and 3 were my complete favorites. They're all really good in their own ways, though, man. Oh, that's a bummer. Ryan, I see you on Steam. God. Okay, I'm gonna try this without killing Kojima.
Boss.
Metal Gear Solid 2 was awesome, but man. 3. So good. I haven't played Peace Walker. I just kind of like zoomed through the story for Peace Walker, so. There we go. Yes! One more week, Ryan. One more week, and my friend Ryan will be here. I'm gonna play some Vigi games. Come on, Kojima. Drive! Maybe I shouldn't use the rockets. Reload! Yeah, Metal Gear, awesome. Crab Battle. That's another good one, too. Why is it still... I killed the truck. Take your time there, Kojima. Oh, man, Rick and Morty. Yeah, dude, do that. What's up, the year, Yano? How are you, Yano? Kill them all! How did he not... There we go. He blew up right in my face. He caught fire. It was just his body on fire in the car. Oh, fuck. Yeah, no. How you doing tonight? I know I need to watch Rick and Morty. I really do. I gotta just sit down. If it was on Netflix or something. I can watch it for free, right? There's websites. Yes? Something I can watch on, like, a tablet while I relax. Oh, these guys. Get him! No, he's still there. There we go. Proximity death. Oh, fuck! There we go. Sweet. My night's awesome, man. Just getting ready for that Metal Gear tomorrow. Or Tuesday, I guess. The only thing that sucks is Steam. I'm getting it on PC, and Steam doesn't let you preload that title. So I'm basically gonna have to download like 34 gigabytes or 50 gigabytes or a million or whatever it's gonna be, like after midnight. So I won't even get to play it until probably like Tuesday night. So I'm bummed about. Got coworkers taking the day off to play it, which is what I would do if I would have remembered to take that time off in advance. Yeah, get into it, Snake. Can I get off that? Okay.
I'm coming.
Good. No obvious injuries, right?
Get that launcher. Oh, I'll take it out. Take it out for a nice dinner. Oh, fuck. Well, that was quick.
Target secured. Now get in the chopper.
Get in the chopper. Roll him.
Yeah. Oh, hell of a way to go. This thing. That guy went flying. Destroy the tower too while we're at it.
That was smooth, boss. Real smooth.
Real smooth.
I'd expect nothing less.
That's right. They call me Big Boss for a reason. Yeah, you Peace Walker. I don't know. Like I said, I kind of skipped on it. Take out this. Oh, wait. Yes! He's still sitting there. Look at him, he's like, I gotta go! That was fantastic. Anybody else want to fuck with Hollywood Cole? All right, finally. All right, guys, I think I'm going to call it a night after this. I got to work in the morning.
We're leaving hot zone.
What time is it? Yeah, probably a good idea.
Confirm. The target is safe.
Oh, yeah, Hideo. For you guys who haven't seen this, I kind of spoiled it, I guess. But it is pretty awesome. Oh man, I can't wait for Metal Gear, like, the Phantom Pain.
What took you so long?
The man that doesn't age. Cool. What did I get? I got like a C or something. I got an A. I didn't even try for that one. Ah, well. Cool. Alright guys, thanks again for watching, man. It was good seeing you guys and all that fun stuff. So I'm going to try to stream more often. Since there's no goddamn notifications on YouTube yet, I'd say just keep an eye out, I guess. Thanks, Yano. Appreciate it, man. If you guys get a chance, I guess the easiest way, I think I'm still going to stream on Twitch because Twitch seems to be the better platform for now. You can follow me at twitch.tv/KevinWK. Add me, hit follow, all that fun stuff. That way you'll get an email knowing when I go online, as opposed to, like I said, just kind of finding out when you're just checking out YouTube. So that's the way it goes. But thanks again, guys. I really appreciate it. Hope you guys have a good night. Have a kick-ass week. We're going to play some Metal Gear soon. All right, later.